I order again the same model, this model that I been tested before. Unfortunately, this spot welding the most bit long due to the thin arteries. Here it is. Even though I upgraded this one, still nothing. It won't useful anymore. So I buy another one because I believe this model can work firmly. Only the problem is the traces. Even though they increase this area, but if this area is too thin, like this. So last time that I did the review in this area, this trace is blown out. It cut all the way, and three most blown up, and also this circuit, spot welding circuit, not useful anymore. Even though I upgraded the thickness. So before I test this one, I need to thicken the trusses, this area. Before I do a test, I need to install this thicker copper in this area so that it won't blow on the MOSFET and destroy the circuit like my first order in the AliExpress. Previous review, this spot welding, this is the same model. The first one, all the most three MOSFET blown up due to the traces thinner, even though I upgraded and replaced a new one. So this circuit's not useful, but I believe that this spot welding work firmly if you can increase the traces of this area. So 0.132, 0.13. So my previous video, this spot welding blown up the MOSFET, even though I test this 0.13 nickel strip, and it's a gear one. Let's try this one. That's a good one. Not work good. There's nothing like that. More strong. Look at that. Too strong. Look at the spot mark at the spot welding. That gear one is firmly weld after increasing the thickness of the traces. No, mostly blown up. So let's check. I'm going to check first. Yeah, it is 0.2. 0.2. So let's try 0.2. As you can see, it's 0.13. The spot welding worked perfectly, but before, just one spot, trim was blown, and also the traces blown up. Oh, look at that. Firmly well. I don't need to rip up this one. As you can see, the spot mark shows clearly that this nickel strip stick to this plate firmly. That's it, you know. Let's try another 0.2 and then let's try to rip it off. Let's try this one. Let's try it only one spot. Like that. As you can see, it's firmly welded. Gonna rip up. Nah, I can't. Firmly welded. At gear 1. What if I try gear 2? Gear 2 double sound. Look at that. Spot mark a bit bigger than this gear 1. This is a gear 2. This 2 spot, and this the first one is a gear 1. Let's try gear 3. That's gear 3, guys. 0.2. Look at 0.2. Yeah, 0.2 nickel strip at gear 3. A bit changes. I'll try 0.3, guys, if these things can work. Almost 0.3, 297, 0.297. So just about, it's about 0.3. Let's start from the gear 1. That's gear 1. Gear 1. Look at the spot mark at 0.3. It's clear not strong enough. So let's try it. Gear 2. This is gear 2. Gear 2, I think it's stick firmly. Gives it the spot mark. Yeah, it's stick. Yeah, it's stick. Yeah, it's really stick. Let's try gear 3. Alright, that guy. This is gear 3. Is it? It's thick. Yeah, it's thick. Yeah, look at that. There's a hole. Let's take gear 3. Yeah, 0.3. Just gear 3. My advice, if you buy a cheap spot welding from Chinese maker, all you need to do is just to increase the thickness to avoid most be blown up. Look at that, after increasing the thickness, nothing's happened. Work firmly, you know? So, I reminded you before you do test from before you do test a cheap spot welding from the Chinese, you should increase the thinner traces. It's only $20, $20 Australian, compared to almost $300 Australian. So look at that, including the battery, it's about, let's say, 100 compared to $300 Australian, so you save $200, right? See you in my next video, guys. I hope that you subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.